Hello, and thank you for a nice introduction. I would like to tell you about a lot of things, but because of the time constraint, I need to focus about on two topics, let's say. And I think I chose it nicely because you could get interested in that. But first, let me introduce what I'm doing. So you can maybe get surprised why I want to study non-relativistic stars or even substellar objects like brown dwarfs of giant planets and even the Earth in modified gravity. So we can say it should not be there. I mean, you should not see that, but it turns out that it does. So firstly, we should notice that some model of modified gravity affects the physics of non-relativistic stars. There's already some papers related to that. I also proposed a few tests related to how to use the, maybe not the data because I'm not the data person, but how to use much more data we have with like many missions to constrain those models. I will use a similar argument to Daniela's that we can say that we understand the non-relativistic star a bit better than neutron stars and black holes. So this is another reason to have a look there. Still, there are a lot of things we do not understand, a lot of problems related to the atmosphere description, but we can say that at least we understand a bit better the density regime, pressure, and so on in those particular objects. Yeah, and like the most important message I would like to take home is that the biggest impact is related to the age of the of those objects. So like cooling models, for example, now the here people were talking a lot about the heating in the core in neutron stars or cooling, so there will be a different rate of the cooling. So if one day you can see an object which behaves like that, don't get too excited that you found dark matter particles, because a similar effect we will have also in modified gravity. So you've seen this picture already a few times. So I will not focus too much about that. So here there's this picture. Now you can find the description here, so I will not focus on that. You have like different kind of objects, like from like cosmology and stellar ones. And this picture can be compared to this picture when you have like different observations and data you can have. So you see that there is a very interesting region here related to the galaxy and stellar region. And this is the region when something interesting must happen. You could see it in the morning talk, you know, like some kind of screening, for example, that we have a lot of troubles here in the cosmological regime. Then something happens and we have a regime in which GR seems to be fine. So, and we see that we are really lacking observations constraint coming from this region. So somehow this is my job to find a possible test to that region. But before going there, let me just give you a few observations. I'm not directly working quantum gravity, but there are like many models of quantum gravity, and many of them has a very interesting feature that the Heisenberg uncertainty principle is modifying those models. And it, similar things can happen with the dispersion relation. It depends on the model what you have. It just please keep it in your mind for a second. Then another observation is that because of that fact I showed you before, we will deal with the modified phase space volume like this. I'm not writing here what that modification is because it depends on the model, but generally the most popular model you have here, the modification is a function of, and this is a quadratic momentum here. So because you have the phase space volume modified, so of course your thermodynamics will also be. Even if this modification is of the Planck scale, you have this modification, you can calculate your microphysics, for example, and you get some modifications which are also an observable effects. People constrain already quantum gravity models with this. And the third observation is that a lot of model of gravity can be treated as an effective theory of quantum gravity. So I guess we should also expect something something happening here because of modified gravity or in gravity in general. So as I said, there is quite a lot of work now, but this is like just the last few years related to that. I would like to really tell you about everything, but I cannot. So let me focus on those two ideas that maybe you will be interested. So about the crystallization in white dwarfs and cooling processes, and also how a particular equation of state, Fermi equation of state, depends on quantum or modified gravity. There are like many indications why equation of state can depend on modified gravity, because when you have a lot of equations which describe your star, your stellar or substellar object, you will start seeing, like with the experience, you will start seeing that there are a lot of things which can be right in the effective way. So for example, opacity can be, it seems to be also modified, I don't know yet. And like many other things, if you are interested, we can talk about that later. So this is, again, here I have non-relativistic equations because they are much easier in modified gravity. Of course, I have also relativistic ones that are much, much uglier as usual. So again, some of those theories can modify non-relativistic equations like Poisson and hydrostatic equilibrium equation in more or less such a way. In the most popular model like scalar tensor, Palatini gravity, this will be a function of energy density and maybe also the radial distance. It depends, no? So of course the hydrostatic equilibrium equations is modified. I mean, to close your system, you need of course matter description, so equation of state, and many others too. And if you have like extra fields, there you will also have some additional equations, but in many fields of gravity, you have include that information already here. So one equation less. And this is the results I obtained with my Indian colleagues related to white dwarfs. So we were interested in cooling model. Firstly, we started a very, very simple cooling model. So this is just the thermal energy. But then we understood that we need to like really take into account crystallization and also other effects, which we are working on now. So, but I want to just notice that all those equations you see, so like the by temperature, the specific heat, and at the end cooling equations we are using to get those pictures, everything depends on rho, on the density. And how you get the density? You get this from the hydrostatic equilibrium equation, which is modified in your model of gravity. So, for example, this is how the specific heat looks in modified gravity. So these dotted curves are modified gravity. Here I studied it for Palatini model, but Palatini gravity, but you will have a similar effect in scalar tensor and other models. And here you have the luminosity. In general, as I promised, as I told you at the very beginning, the age of the objects in modified gravity is the thing which is like really affected. So, and also I have other works related to non-relativistic stars. And yes, it can be that we have ages of, I don't know, of the sun or the solar system or some clusters and so on in the wrong way, because you need to assume Newtonian physics or GR or other model of gravity to get those ages. So this is just the indication, but there are more works related to the ages. And the last thing I just wanted to also discuss with you a bit is yeah, how the equation of state can depend on gravity or quantum gravity or modified gravity. So I am interested in the set of equations which can describe my star. No, and let's take like a very simple model. I want to have a self-gravitating fermions, a ball, spherical symmetric, and I will put it in a box in such a way, you know, not to have the evaporation, so this is a micro-canonical system. So you already see, I mean, you can write the local variables and global variables, so the only, let's say, assumption I have here, because I am interested in fermions, so I need to take into account the Pauli exclusive principle, so you already like can calculate from combinatorics the form of the specific entropy. So you have this, and as I said, I would like to have like all equations which describe my star. And just have a look here, what is happening in the energy, This is a gravitational potential, no, which, as I showed you a few slides ago, can be modified in modified gravity. I have also the equations for the relativistic case, for modified gravity, GR. They are ugly, so please see here if you are interested. This is just for non-relativistic star. So, as I said, I would like to have a set of equations which describe in a consistent way my star. So, I can consider the maximization of all those equations I have. So, maximization of the entropy when the energy, when the mass energy and particle number are fixed. So, this is like a well-known method. So, going through this procedure, I can get the equations which will describe a thermodynamically stable system. And what is happening when you do that? Yeah, you get that your equations need to take into account gravity. No? Let me remind that gravity is represented here by this gravitational potential. In modified gravity, this gravitational potential can be modified or not. It depends on your theory of gravity. In the modified gravities I work on, this potential is modified. So my hydrostatic equilibrium equation is modified. The same will happen for a full relativistic case, it's just the equations are more complicated. So we have here that dependence. We can play with those equations to write our equation of state for Fermi gas at finite temperature in this way. And I corrected this. So at the end, you see that you have that dependence. If you have a magnetic field, for example, no, in your you want to consider a magnetic star, you will also have a magnetic field included in the chemical potential. So this alpha zero is related to the like the zero order approximation to the Fermi energy, but further terms are related to any field you have in your description. Yeah, so I think I should finish soon. So firstly, whatever theory you are working on, you need to be consistent. It also happens that a lot of data related to stellar physics are theory dependent, like for example, lithium depletion, which you use to say how old a given star or globular cluster is. And this is really highly affected by modified gravity or like any model of gravity you want to use, you will get different numbers, you will get different age of your star. The same happens with our Jupiter. I mean, you can also write the, consider the evolutionary model of Jupiter, and you will also obtain different numbers than when you assume Newtonian physics and so on. So firstly, we should be consistent, so use the equations describing everything, so don't do that, okay, for cosmology I will use, some modified gravity, but then when I talk about stars, I will use Newtonian physics. No, because that modified gravity used in cosmology can also affect the physics of your star. Of course, it depends on the model of gravity. And the models I am studying so far, most of them are toy model. I mean, so for example, they are not rotating. But in a moment, Shashwata will tell you about how to incorporate the rotation. Yes, it was about rotation. we should also take into account magnetic fields. We should describe properly atmospheres, which are very complicated. And I think many of people here know that. So we should also take it into account. There are a lot of like ready codes, like MESA, for example. But be very careful with MESA, because they assume a lot. I mean, like, for example, the gravitational constant is the Newtonian one, and if you work in a scalar tensor, you should, also, of course, take it into account, and so on and so on. There is really a lot I would like to tell you, but maybe we can do it during a break. Thank you.
Thank you very much for the great talk. There is one question over there.
Thank you very much for the nice talk, Aneta. So I have two quick questions. One is about the value that you find for the Chandrasekhar mass. Mm-hmm. And the second question is whether with these modifications of gravity to the thermodynamical quantities, do you derive a different thermodynamic corrections, and is it possible to check it on the laboratory or something like that?
Yes, I hope so. I mean, regarding the last question, I hope so. I didn't talk about that, but I have also work related to the planetary seismology, which, I mean, you can use seismic data to construct your fear of gravity with earthquakes or Mars quake soon. And what happens in modified gravity and quantum gravity that you, for example, when you have solid, now you can describe it, for example, by some crystal or whatever, and you see the differences. I mean, when you because you need to use, in some moment, you need to use gravitational potential, hydrostatic equilibrium equations. Of course, if you have modifications, you will have different structure. And I believe that it can be possible, but maybe when we start having bases on the Moon or on the Mars, because for sure we should obtain different numbers when we do experiments on the Earth and when we do experiments on other planets with different G. So yes, I think this can be a constraint, and I am developing that topic, so we can also discuss about that. And regarding the Chandrasekhar mass, what you wanted to ask? Honestly, now I don't remember. I would have to. So for example, here you see that for negative values of the parameter, you don't have a Chandrasekhar mass at all. So you have like a smooth. You can go smoothly to neutron star regime, for example. No, and because there are already sub Chandrasekhar cases and super Chandrasekhar ones, modified gravity, not particularly this model. I mean, you can have even models of modified gravity, this kind of situation. But so here you have like unstable stars, so this maybe could explain those sub Chandrasekhar masses. And here, as I said, this model here, we are using a Chandrasekhar equation of state, which should also be modified. Like here, I show you for the non-relativistic equations, but if you incorporate in the full relativistic equations, you will get a modified Chandrasekhar equation of state. But the equations are really very complicated, and I didn't want to show you. I think this is quite evident from here, but Chandrasekhar equation of state is also modified, and we didn't take it into account here. And this is, for example, the next step we want to do, to consider this feature, and also to consider more physics, no? Because even the crystallization, there is still this neutrino stuff we need to learn and see if modified gravity has something to tell about that. I am talking too much again, sorry.
Don't worry at all, it's super interesting, but I think we need to break here.
Yes.
So thank our speaker again for the very nice talk.